and we are coming, and we will not stop, we will not relent until your country is free.
Represent the overwhelming majority of the Irish people in this protest against the use of Shannon Airport for American war efforts.
I think it's completely hypocritical of Bertie Ahern and our government to claim on the one hand that they're getting so-called declarations in relation to Nice so that Ireland won't participate in a military action which has no UN mandate, while at the very same time they have been for quite some time now, and they are apparently going to continue to do so, to facilitate a war effort which has clearly no UN mandate.
Say that the troops who land in there are going to go out and deal with a war criminal and a dictator. Are they going to go to Jerusalem and arrest Ariel Sharon?
Oh, Sergeant, I'm a draftee and I've just arrived in camp. I've come to wear the uniform and join the martial tramp. And I want to do my duty, but one thing I do implore, you must give me lessons, Sergeant, for I've never killed before. To do my job obediently is my only desire. To learn my weapon thoroughly and how to aim and fire. To learn to kill the enemy, then to slaughter more. Oh, I'll need instruction, Sergeant, for I've never killed before. Now there are rumors in the camp about our enemy. They say that when you see him, he looks just like you and me. But you deny it, Sergeant, and you are a man of war. So you must give me lessons, for I've never killed before. Now there are several lessons that I haven't mastered yet. I haven't got the hang of how to use the bayonet. If he doesn't die at once, am I to stick him with it more? Oh, I hope you will be patient, for I've never
killed before. Because this issue is also real to her, and so unreal to the people of power and profit in this country. Where we stand today, Irish neutrality, that tradition has been reduced to virtual neutrality. These people don't live in the real world. It's a virtual reality. It's similar to that in Derry, an arms factory owned by Raytheon that contributes so much weapons to this next war and the last Gulf War was opened by two Nobel Peace Prize winners.
Yeah,
that's a virtual reality these people live in, so far from the real world, so far from the consequences of the bombs they drop, the sanctions they impose. Think about this place as well. This place at the moment is a place of death in terms of whatever they're moving through here. And Irish customs do not check whether they're moving depleted uranium munitions through here. They don't check whether they're shanghaiing people from the Cuban prison camps to sympathetic regimes that may interrogate with torture.
Very emotional for me.
places that these troops out here are going to are places I know. I left with my family. I'm just an ordinary Iraqi. I'm not involved in any political organizations, and it's just very scary to see what's happening here. And the drive to war, the idea that it's inevitable, that it's just the way it's going to happen. It's just the way things are going to be sorted out. The Iraqi people have suffered for almost 30 years under Saddam Hussein, who was backed by the Americans and the British and the French to oppress the Iraqi people. Kurds, Shias, Sunnis, Muslims, Christians, Druze, all the Iraqi people have been oppressed by Saddam, supported by the West, and the West watched because it served their purposes. He doesn't serve their purpose anymore, so they obviously want to go in and put another puppet regime. My mother and father are over on a visit from Britain, and they actually were kind of worried about me coming here. The fear is so instilled in them that somebody will see me, or I'm an Iraqi, or something will happen. But we need to speak out. I probably don't make any sense at all. The troops who are in there now, they are going to go and kill people. Real people like we are here. It's very real. It's not something, it's real. It's just real. We need to remember that. If there's anything that any of you can do, speak about it, write about it, tell your friends, your families about what's happening. Tell them there is another way. Let the Iraqi people find justice for themselves. America and the UN were the ones who started the whole sanctions against Iraq. As Kieran was saying, and Dennis Halliday, who was responsible for the implementing the food for oil program, and he resigned as a result of the effects he saw in Iraq. More than 500,000 children have died as a direct result. 500,000 children under 5, let alone the other people who've had cancers, all kinds of problems. It's not going to go away. All of this is not going to go away. We do need to sort it out, but we need the Iraqi people to sort it out. Not some imperialist foreign power who's going to come and force what they want on their own. Yeah. Putting themselves forward. So thank you very much, and God bless you all.